Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, you are welcome to another tutorial. As I said in the previous tutorial, today we are going to solve or to do an example concerning with errors. As you see on the paper below, we have an example which says the period of an oscillation of a simple pendulum in an experiment is recorded as 2.63 second, 2.56 second, 2.42 seconds, 2.71 seconds, 2.80 seconds respectively. Find A, mean time period, and part 2, we are required to find the absolute error in each observation and the percentage error. So avoid the stage of time in solution. Here we have many readings which are records of period of oscillation of a simple pendulum in that particular experiment. We are recorded as follows. It means we have first reading, second reading, third reading, fourth reading, and the fifth reading. It means we have five readings. So from those five readings, we are required to find mean time period. Mean time period is the same as the true value. And in previous tutorial, I showed you how to find the true value. The true value is the same as mean time period. So the mean time period, mean time period is given by, because these are periods, we are going to sum all periods. It will be T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4 plus T5, because we have five periods, and then divide with number of periods in this experiment. So this can be written as mean time period, which is denoted with capital letter T, and we put bar on top of capital letter D, on top of capital letter T, to be mean time period, which is equal to, this one can be written in sigma notation, as I have shown you in the previous tutorial, is 1 over n sigma notation. We start from I is equal to 1 to I is equal to n, and then period, not A, period I. It means if I is equal to 1, it will be T1. I is equal to 2, it will be T2, and so on. So this formula and this one, or these two formulae, are the same. So to find mean period, part 1 is equal to, you can add all readings. We have 2.63 plus 2.56 plus 2.42 plus 2.71 plus 2.80 divided with number of reading, which is 5. We have 5 readings. So this can be written according to this secondary formula, can be written as 1 over 5, because number of reading are 5, and then summation of I is equal to 1 to the last reading, which we have 5 readings, which is our n, and then we sum 2.63 plus 2.56 plus 2.42 plus 2.71 plus 2.80. So when you perform this calculation, you will obtain mean time period, which is equal to 2.62 seconds. This is the mean time period. And bear in mind that mean time period is the same as true value. Mean time period, which is 2.62 seconds, is the same as, is equal to true value, which is equal to exact value. Exact value. Okay, I hope we have completed with part one. We enter in another part, which is part two. We are required, part two, we are required to find absolute error in each observation. Here, when you observe in this question, we have five observations. So we are required to find absolute error for each observation. To find absolute error for each observation, we have to take this true value, this one, true value or exact value, and subtract each reading. So the answer obtained, it will be absolute error of that reading. So we start with the first reading. The true value or exact value, which is our mean time period, is equal to 2.62 seconds. So to find absolute error for each reading, it means we take this true value, which is 2.62, minus the first reading, which is 2.63. Also, for the second reading, it will be 2.62 minus 2.56. For the third reading, it will be that one minus 2.42. For the third one, it will be 2.62 minus 2.71. For the last reading, it will be 2.62 minus 2.80. So the answers obtained will be absolute errors for each reading. So when you take a calculator, it will be 2.62 minus 2.63, which is equal to this one. I'm sorry, 2.62 minus 2.63. The answer will be negative 0.01. And for other, it will be here, it will be 0.06, but they are seconds. Here it will be 0.20 second. Here it will be negative 0.09 second. Here it will be 0.18 second. All these are absolute errors for each reading. So this one is the absolute error for this reading, absolute error for this reading. So I hope we have answered a part two. Also, we can find mean absolute error. To find mean absolute error, we have to sum all absolute errors. We can write summation of all absolute errors, which are this one. But there are some of absolute errors which are negative. In order to remove those negative sign, we have to put absolute sign, and then we divide with the number of readings or number of absolute errors, like that one. So there you will obtain mean absolute error. So mean absolute error, it will be equal to summation of all readings, which is 0.01 plus this negative sign here becomes positive due to this absolute sign, plus 0.06 plus 0.205 plus 0.09 and the last one plus 0.180. Divide with the number of reading, we have 5 reading. So the mean absolute error, it will be equal to 0.11 second. So this is the mean absolute error for all readings. So now we can write our true value or exact value. The result can be reading, can be written by including the true values, which is 2.62 plus or minus the mean absolute error, which is 0.11 in bracket. The unit is seconds. So this is our result. It can be written in this form. It means this one is true value or exact value or actual value. And this one is absolute error, because we have many readings. This one is mean absolute error. From this one, we can find the percentage error. We can find the fractional or relative error. Let us start to find the fractional error. Okay, we have this one. We have our period with its error, which is 2.62 plus or minus 0.11 second. This is our mean time period together with its mean absolute error. So from there we can find fractional error, which is given by taking absolute error divided with exact value or true value. So it means now our fractional error, it will be equal to 0.11 divided with 2.62. So when you divide there, we have 0.11 divided with 2.62. The answer is that one. So it means our fractional error or relative error is equal to 0.041. That is our fractional error. You may be asked to find the percentage error. Percentage error. We said percentage error is the expression of fractional error into percentage, and the formula to find percentage error is equal to absolute error divided with exact value multiplied with 100%. This is the formula to find percentage error. But when you observe in this formula to find percentage error, this one is fractional error. That's why we say is the same as we take fractional error multiply with 100%. Absolute error over exact error is fractional error, as you see. So it's the same as you take fractional error multiply with 100. But fractional error, this will be percentage error. Percentage error is equal to fractional error we have obtained is 0.041. When you multiply with 100%, we will obtain percentage error, which is equal to the answer there. You multiply with 100, so our percentage error, it will be 4.1980%. So this can be approximated to be 4.2%. So this is our percentage error. So thank you for watching this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the subscribe button and remember to hit the bell beside the subscribe button in order to be notified when I upload different videos about the advanced level physics. You are most welcome. Thank you.